a few of you guys questions that you had to ask about basically being a bottle girl and being a cocktail waitress. How you get the job. Every club is really different. Some clubs you have to go and audition. Some clubs, you know, you need to fill out an application. And some clubs just hire you the next day. It just really depends on the club. But most importantly, you really just need to talk to a manager. And probably go into the club first to see what the environment is like before you even try to work there. Because you might not be comfortable with the environment.
Oh, I can add to that. And if you've never did it, don't.
She's telling me
why. Oh. Hi, guys. I'm Lakeisha. Another thing you should keep in mind is if you're going into a place where you're stepping out of a comfort zone, you have to build your mental to be able to do the things that you need to do to get the money. Because some people come in there not knowing how to dance, not knowing what to do, but they know they want to get the money. And when you're doing auditions, you have to show out. So mentally prepare yourself for coming into an atmosphere that you've never been in.
Yeah, that's very true. Before I even started jobs like this, I had to watch a lot of videos and just read a lot of articles just to see how people just deal with having a job like this, because it is so much social stigma attached to it. It's kind of hard sometimes, but
I can agree, because I feel like if I would have never seen the girls that put me on prior to starting, how much money they was bringing in, I wouldn't have been hyped for it. I wouldn't have been able to experience, see it firsthand. I probably would have went in there scared as fuck. I mean, I was nervous, but still. But
what it's like? I feel like at our club, it's pretty chill. Like, it's kind of like getting paid to party, really. Like, we really just pop bottles, make drinks, and just turn up with the crowd. That's really just what we do. And make money off of it, so.
Oh, this strip club after me, what's up?
Young Money.
Yeah. Me and my will put on the AOD back to back. Little AMG 63s. I tell all my hoes, rake it up, break it down, bag it up. Fuck it up, fuck it up, fuck it up, fuck it up. Bag it up, bag it up, bag it up, bag it up. Rake it up, rake it up, rake it up.
I do occasionally get hate, and it is going to be females that try to interfere with your hustle.
Not occasionally.
Very frequently, those few people, it's
gonna be those few females at any place you work at, any club you work at, it's gonna be like that. Prepare yourself for that and just know that you're not there to make friends. And if it happens, it happens and revives. But just know that
not every club.
Everybody's there for that money. Nobody's there for no friendship. Nobody's there for you, but them niggas make that shmoney.
Now, if you're lucky, you might come into somebody that you actually vibe with and they're a genuine person, but you also have to watch that, because sometimes bitches will be, females will befriend you just to reap the benefits of whatever comes with being associated with you. If you making
true
money,
shit.
They think they always gonna make money with you.
Oh, that's another thing. At our place of work, there, females will see a guy that you're entertaining and feel the need to go and help you entertain them and help you take the money out of his pockets. And I had the firsthand experience that, and tell the girl, like, nah, I'm good. You just have to stand up. It's gonna change
who you are. Like, yeah, it'll bring you into a lot of confidence. Just being comfortable with your sexuality enough just to kind of be more revealed. Like, just not naked, but revealed. You know, showing your real self.
Yeah.
Yeah. It brings you into a lot of confidence and a lot of assertiveness. I like it personally. It was a little growth challenge for me.
And be able to stick up and speak up.
That part, and it's fun. It's like being able to be a little wild, because you still are young.
It's better than stripping.
Bitch, I'm rocking chain like a feel nigga. How the fuck you? Heard you getting money, how I feel nigga. She coolin' with a real one, how I feel, baby. She coolin' with a real one, how I feel, baby. Heard you getting nigga, gonna build it. Money made the world turn. Money made the world turn. Got my haters salty, got them niggas catching heartburn. I was in the street to try and sell this.
Another question a lot of people ask me, well, are you a stripper or are you a go-go dancer? Because they see us dancing and we also serve bottles. Or are you straight cocktail waitress?
We are connoisseur. We do all three. We do all of the above.
What's up? We don't strip.
Yeah, no. We don't take off clothes at all three. We have to actually be pretty covered. For what I would say for a club
environment.
This is us. I mean, shit. Yeah, honestly, this is our fits for tonight. Like, you wear this with some fishnets, some tights or something. Whatever you want to do to jazz it up, but yeah, that's basically what we wear.
We are not the same. We're not the same. Same color t-shirt, white, long toe. We are not the same.
What? everything. When I say mental, I'm always on some mental stuff. Even outside of work, when people that known you for years or people that known you outside of that work environment, they will change their outlook on you. And it can be for the good to know that, oh, she's a boss, she's gonna do whatever she has to do. And then it can also come with the bag, or she's shaking her ass for money, or whatever the case would be. But just be mentally prepared in all aspects.
Man, you really can't worry what people gotta say. You gotta, look, we grown. Once you get older, you just stop worrying about stuff like that. You ain't gonna worry about your daddy, your grandma, what your friend you used to go to school with. You don't worry about that, because then do they pay your bills? Do they put money in your pocket?
Sometimes they even hate because you on some shit that they want to be on. So
honestly,
and you're making money. Like, you're gonna, if, whenever you get comfortable, you're gonna bring that bread home, and then they're gonna see if you're one of those people that the flex. But obviously, if you stay there after the first couple of times, they're gonna see that you're making good money.
So biggest tip, do you?
Yeah.
On the pay, let's give you the last question. Pay, just like any club, it depends on the night, to be for real. Like, there's always slow nights you might walk home with a little chump change. Then there's nights you might walk home with car payment. Shit, good night, a mortgage payment, goddamn. But it just really depends on the night.
Young nigga, let's get
the bag way.
Thumbing through these hundreds, I get it the bag way. Bag way. Flexing any foreigns, I did it the bag way. She ain't fucking with you unless it's the bag way. The bag way. I can blow a bag on a bag way.
Yeah.
I just blew a bag on a Tuesday. Yeah. All my bad and bougie. I'm a savage nigga, little web and boost. If you ain't talking money, you gon' lose me. Facts, I sell packs, I blow racks, I shoot moves. I'm no ordinary nigga, I got swag, ho. I'm in my last hoe, my pass hoe. Yeah, my neck and my wrist is a bag. I pull off the lot paper tag. If you broke, then go get you some cash. I'm puffing and choking on gas. 93, that's diesel. Rockstar like the Beatles. All I dreamed about was a bag. Get the money first, never last. Hey.
Now go get a check.
Hey.
Now go get a check.
The bag way.
If your hustle's strong enough, it don't. A slow night don't mean nothing for you. That's just average money. Like,
and note before we end it, I feel like the hustle is in everything. The talk game.
It's not even about looks, to be honest.
No.
Don't think you're gonna get paid just because you're pretty. No. I wish, but yeah. No. Your hustle got to be on. Your talk game. You got to be assertive. You got to be straightforward. You got to be able to be confident and being sexy. And it's. Tell you.
It's gonna show though, because if you're not out there getting that money while everybody out there hunting that shit down, it's gonna show that you got a little bit of confidence you need to build.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, definitely.
Pay is good though. On some nights, and sometimes that shit is bad, but you gotta stick through it.
Okay, guys. So we're just at our local Waffle House having breakfast after work. That's basically what it's like in the nightlife. It is, what, like 7 o'clock in the morning? Got off like 2 hours ago. Just enjoy breakfast, like, you know, regular day. Regular Sunday morning.
But yeah. Fuck what people think. Get that shmoney. It's not bad. Who cares?
We're young.
Yes, YOLO.
50 like, years from now, who's even gonna remember this shit? Like, this is be a cool ass story to tell our grandparents.
It's gonna be like, oh damn, she just got a car. She just paid some shit off. You know what I'm saying?
She just bought a house. Like,
she got her license for a microblading. Like, this bitch just built a business off of this shit. Cause yeah. That's what I'm speaking into. This and like, you just gotta say fuck it and go for it.